along with that. What do you guys make that call?
She's never gave up. Really just trusted our teammates to make big plays. Justin drafted two key layups, got us down six. Then we just kept chipping away. Scott stops, kept chipping away. And then Taven Jackson, it's a huge shot, so helped us. And then Spencer hits one free throw, put us up three, so we could foul at the end and they couldn't get the game.
Taven doing that as a freshman, did that surprise you?
It was a big shot, I'm not gonna lie. It takes a pretty big person to do that, and he stepped up and then he
what's it like seeing him do that in that moment? I mean, that's, are you proud of him, or are you?
I have the biggest smile on my face. That's nothing but respect for that kid. He works super hard every day. So, and I knew he wanted that moment, and I just knew right when he shot it.
He's kind of that type of athlete, and he comes up.
Yeah, see, he got a few things. He's got a few things, football, basketball. So.
Trayce, what was the look?
Emotions of committing.
Just overwhelming a little bit, a little bit nervous, don't want to let the fans down, but then you just got to settle and play your game. I miss a few key buttons, miss a few free throws, but it's going to happen in the end of the game, so just got to find a way to win. And just my teammates carry me, they pick me up when I do stuff wrong, so we're just going to keep chipping away and just try to get wins.
What kind of led up to today, making the decision today?
I kind of had it planned out, but I never had a chance to call the coaches because I was always busy. So I had it planned out from like Tuesday-ish, and then I decided that Friday, what better way to do it than having two IU commits play today. So,
what was it like going against Armand tonight, your future teammate?
He played really well. He did a lot of good things out there. He crashed the boards, handled the ball really well, shot the ball really well, so just things that we don't need to do next year.
So you made your final decision, you made your decision Tuesday?
Yeah. I actually made it last week, but I didn't really like tell anyone until Tuesday. Like I told my family and stuff like that.
Was there a particular moment that kind of made you know that Indiana was the choice?
I just think it wasn't really a particular moment. I just think over time when I see them come to every first event, then over time you're finally like, they're dedicated and they want you. So. And it's also a place where they need you. So.
What did that mean to you last week to see the whole staff out there watching your game last Friday?
It meant a lot. It meant that they truly care about me. Sending all four coaches, that's a pretty big deal. So it meant a lot to me.
Just this last week, how much of a relief has it been just to have that decision in the rear view and moving on?
It was still a little bit of a pressure just to tell everyone, but a lot of stress off the shoulders. Can focus on just this high school season, so I think it's going to help further on during the season.
Romeo and Rob were here tonight. Did you know they were coming to watch today?
Yeah, I did. I texted Romeo earlier this week. I was like, we're going to come to the game. He's like, yeah, so good seeing them, good supporting.
How much does Romeo being there or Romeo ending up at IU, another talented in-state kid, how much does that kind of factor into your eventual decision?
It definitely has an effect. I don't know if I'm going to play with him because he usually could be a one and done. But at the same time, just seeing all the love that he got just makes you want to stay and stay and just play for your fans and for your home state.
And going against Armand tonight, what were some things you maybe learned about his game that you didn't know before?
There wasn't really anything new that I learned, but just how strong he is with the ball, just how he can take it from point A to point B, and he's really crafty. So, and he's a hustler. He likes to take charges. So, just things I love.
What's to say about that staff now that they've got so many in-state guys coming in? Is there something to that, do you think, as far as recruiting momentum?
I think that we have some recruiting momentum. I think that with me and Armand, we can try to get one or two more people in the class. My goal is to try to get Keon Brooks, so that's my main goal right now. So. I'm going to try to work hard for him that way.
Have you reached out to him yet?
Yeah, I reached out to him earlier, so I'm going to stay in touch with him, but it's still his decision, and he needs to make the best for him.
What's he saying? Do you get any sense of what he's feeling?
Not really yet. Just talked briefly, nothing really big.
Right. Do you think you two guys could compliment each other on the college team?
Most definitely. Just the same as we played in AU. We love coming off the ball screens with each other, so I just think that could switch over to college level really well.
How much was Armand talking to you? I know he was always trying to get you to Indiana. I mean, was that something you've kind of been hearing from him throughout the process?
Me and Armand talk almost every day. So, yeah, he was a big part of it. I talked to Rob, I talked to Romeo, I talked to all of them. So it was all honestly a huge, just everyone just made me feel welcome. So, and that really helped me understand state. Then you have all the fans on top of that. So it just really helps.
How were those calls to the other coaches telling you, no, you're not going there?
It was hard, not easy. But I think the coaches really took it well. They just wanted the best for me and my future, and they said, if that's where your heart is, then I can't be mad at you. And they all wish me best of luck, so it just tells them really about their character and how good of a coach they actually are.
On the flip side of that, what was the IU staff's reaction when you finally formed out?
They were really happy. Really, really happy. They wanted to come see me every day. Coach O, I'm pretty sure, has already been up here three or four times, so that just shows how much they really wanted me and how much they care.
Did you tell them Tuesday or today?
No, they've known for a little bit. Okay. So they've known, and then I told my parents, and my parents are the only one that happened. So, like, parents are the only ones.
It's really good secret keeping.
Yeah, yes.
There was a moment in that first half where you turned to your bench and kind of pointed and said, give me the ball. Did you kind of feel like you wanted to have a statement game in it?
It wasn't really just a statement game, but I just felt like they had a smaller guy on me, so I could take him in the post. If they doubled down, then I could kick it out to shooters. Because in the first quarter, we got a lot of easy buckets off that, so just didn't transition into the second quarter, so we just need to keep playing inside out.
He picked up three fouls, and they began driving and picked up that 8-10 point lead. So what, the start of the fourth quarter, what, pretty much decided to come back out and come back out hard?
Yeah, basically. So picking up that third foul was rough, but just got to play through it, just try to time everything without getting any body on them. So it's really hard to do, but at the same time, you just got to help your team win and just alter their shots so they're not easy layups.
Okay, that comeback, kind of walk us through that from a coach's viewpoint, what he wanted you guys to do and how well everybody performed.
With our coach never thought we were out of the game ever. We just had to keep chipping away. 10 points, 8 minutes is a long time. So we just kept chipping away and chipping away. Got stops. Our coach said 3 stops in a row. We needed stops. I had a big one with 2 blocks, so that really helped us. And then we just made shots, made easy baskets. So they started getting a little flustered down the stretch, and we took advantage.
Taven didn't steal your thunder today, did he? With this?
No, I'm happy that he stole it. I'm happy with him. Hey, as long as we get the win, anything's fine with me.
What do you guys need to do better from moving forward out of this game, do you think?
Definitely stronger with the ball. I think we start kind of play soft, and then definitely on-ball defense, especially with our guards a little bit. We got Mayshawn, who's also a great player. He played really well tonight. So we just got to be tougher with the ball, because mid competition, mid point guards, all point guards, honestly, in general, that we play against are going to be tough with the ball like that. So we just got to be prepared for it.
You've played big games and big crowds before, playing international. What about the atmosphere tonight?
I think it's one of the biggest ones we've had. It was huge, and they really helped us on this last stretch. Made him miss 3 free throws because of the noise, so we're going to need that every night, especially with big games like this. So they're the 6th man tonight, and they really helped us.
Thank you, Trayce.
Thanks, Trayce. I might have missed it.